be the one to outlast me.
I've done that, Bob. Who are you?
If you came with me, I could. Mary. Sensible. You haven't earned this, but they suit you. Good fortune to you.
I see some color first.
Will this do? In all your years out here, you could never achieve what I've done in one fifth the time. Because you're a good man, Edward, see? Goodness is your disease.
That's my prize, Roberts. I'm giving it here!
Remember my creed, boy. A short life and a merry one, that is all. The world owes us nothing more than this. So take what you will, and then die before you live to see yourself made a fool.
Give it here.
That's right, boy, take it. I'll sweat it, you maggot. I'll cut you down!
Kenway, it's prizes, plunder, and adventure ahead. Are you game?
Out of my way, Ben.
Here's a glass to freedom, lads.
Here's to gentlemen of fortune and women of leisure.
To a world full of rogues, better than all the kings and queens that kick us about.
As gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. What man with a sensible mind would choose the former life? For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and, withdrawing them, find it better to be a commander than a common man!
Mm-hmm.
thumping and rustling of feathers. The jackdaw came down swiftly and clutched at the coat of a large ram. But when he tried to fly away, he found he could not lift the animal, for his size and strength were not up to the task. And even as the jackdaw struggled, the ram hardly noticed it was there. Nearby, just across the field, the shepherd saw the fluttering bird and was quite amused. Running up, he captured the jackdaw and clipped its wings. That evening, he gave the jackdaw to his children as a gift. "What an odd little bird this is, Father," he asked and shouted. "What do you call him?" "This is a jackdaw," Father said. "But if you should ask him, he would claim to be